continues right through until the game starts. And when Danny Morrison bowled his first ball, the roar from the crowd that was here then must have been an enormous lift for the New Zealand team.
Well, it is, and I think John Wright pointed it out before. You get you like to feel part of the game. The public are almost right on top of you down there in the terraces where Chris Cairns is fielding. And while he's doing well, they're right behind him. Should he drop a catch or something, he may wish to change his spot on the fields to somewhere a bit quieter. But you have a lot of fun, and you just detected this morning when you saw the New Zealand side warm up, there was a lot of anxiety, a lot of aggression in their preparation, and I just had the feeling then that they may be in for a good day. We'll just have to wait and see.
Well, Pringle has been taken out of the attack. Done a wonderful job, and Gavin Larson coming in for his first ball.
Well, one of Gavin Larson's trademarks is his accuracy. That is why he has been such a valuable one-day player for New Zealand over the years. We'll talk about why he can't play tests as well. We'll wait to see in the months ahead whether he's involved in the Tour of England. But Gavin Larson certainly will not let Ken Rutherford down in terms of the line and length that he bowls. But renowned for bowling to the fields, the captain sets.
Beautifully fielded by Rutherford. And that was the sore hand too, remember?
Well, leading by example, Ken Rutherford. This is a loose delivery from Larson. Put the mockers on him there, and Malik seized on it. But that is world-class fielding in the covers from Rutherford. That's the kind of thing that lifts the whole side. Someone's got to try and beat that now.
I just had the feeling too that the hand is still sore. It was the feel of protection, just not trying to move it too much. He didn't want to show anything. Well, you can see it there. I think it has hurt.
Pretty brave boy, Otago boy, Peter. South Island man.
Beat him tough down in the south. Wide ball called, but a very loose shot from Salim Malik. He went to it and was drawn.
Malik's almost said to the umpire, I'll just have a little swing at this, and looks back at him as if to say, well, you've got to wide that one, sir, and he obliged.
Oh, it's wobbled by Larson. So once again, the movement from the New Zealand bowlers is giving the Pakistan batsman a great deal of concern.
Well, Malik smiles because he knows that was far too good for him. And that's Gavin Larson at his best. Only blame the reaction from his is just to say, well, he's missed that by quite considerable margin. That's how good it was. And in goes another slip again. So Ken Rutherford still looking for the wickets, and he wants to get rid of Malik very early on.
That's pretty close to wide again. In fact, Doug Carey says it was.
Well, the one thing you look for is consistency, I guess, in these umpiring decisions in terms of the wides. And Doug Carey has given that one a wide as well. And sometimes I think the reaction of the batsman is the giveaway thing. He sort of looks away in disgust and then back at the umpire as if to say, come on, come on. Especially as he's the captain as well.